Hey there, friends! eCatalog is the source of different products. Do you want to learn how eCatalog panel works? Then stay with me for a couple of minutes. Here's Reza. Welcome! You can see a few folders on the left side and the preview here on the right. Let me drag this bit to right to have a larger preview. By clicking on collections, you can hide the folders and have only the previews. Then this drop-down menu will help you to navigate through the folders. Let's go back to how it was. There is a plus sign over here. If you click on it, there is the choice to refresh your eCatalog. Then to edit or add sources, you can see the previous version's components are available here to keep a local copy or then visible. And you can also see the location if they are in your own system or remotely. You can also add a new source from a server from an online location that you or your colleagues want to share components between each other, and maybe someone is updating them and it's being updated for everyone else at the same time. Or then you can add a local folder in your computer as a source. Let me close all this. What else do we have here? We can add a collection, we can add a collection group, put that collection in the specific group. And then, for example, let's have a zero in this collection, a three-finger gripper, three light tower. Then in the group one and also in the collection one, we have these three components as a collection. Honestly, it may make no sense why they are next to each other, but for the sake of a little practice, it was nice to do it this way. Then we have the add smart collection. So here we can see already on the left side that we have models by type and models by manufacturer. These are two smart collections that we have put for you by default, and it's clear from the name that they are arranging the components by type and by manufacturer. But you can also make your own kind of collections. You can say the collection is all models, and for example the manufacturer is some specific manufacturer. We have quite many available. Lots of components come from originally these manufacturers. Or then if you want to, for example, say that the type is, for example, conveyors. If I put C over here, you can see that conveyors is available here. And then you can say that another condition, manufacturer, is someone specific. So that's how you can create a specific collection, which is called smart collection, and group them by one of these based on the name, for example. That's how you start a smart collection and put it in your ECAD over here. And components are previewed or sorted by, for example, name in the ascending as default. You can make it descending, or you can arrange them based on other details as you see over here. The preview is by default normal icons. You can make it, for example, small icons to view more in your view. Look, now the robots are so cute, they are small and you have more components in same view. Then there is the list view. What I like is this details. So now I have put here the name next to modification date, visual components ID, and then type. If I go right click here, you can edit the columns as well. You can just define what you want to be added in those columns. For example, there is description. Let's add it to the column on the right and then press OK. So then now here the column description is added. And as you can see, the description started to be for some of the components quite huge. And the reason for it is that there is the metadata. So in the description, we say how to use that specific component. Also, this modification date is nice because you can see when was this component updated the last time. If you press on modified, it will order everything in ascending, and let's change it to descending. So this is the latest component now being updated when I'm making this tutorial. And in this way, you can understand that which components have been updated so you start to utilize them. And then you can see also here on the left, you can view components, layouts, or also files, but I have usually files hidden. That means that if you add a source and inside that source there are some files, it will also preview it for you inside this preview bar. Change it back to what it was. Okay, this was what I wanted to go through with you. Hope it was some useful information. See you in other videos. Take care and bye for now.